Hey everyone, today I will be breaking down the cinematography of Wong Kar-wai's masterpiece, In the Mood for Love, shot by Christopher Doyle. This is Frame by Frame. In the Mood for Love by Wong Kar-wai is a tragic romance story. It's about two lovers living in the same apartment complex. Both of their significant others are cheating on each other, and the two of them are left to wander the city and come to terms with this. Hence, they fall in love themselves, but it will never happen. The specs for the film are simple. It was shot by Christopher Doyle, mostly handheld and on tripod. It was shot in a 1.66 aspect ratio, with a Arriflex 35BL4 and an Arriflex 535 with Zeiss lenses. The film format was Kodak Vision 500T. There was a large focus on tungsten lighting throughout the film, as you will see. And there's a heavy influx of magenta and cyan in the color. It's widely considered as one of the greatest shot films of all time. Most cinematographers will rank it high on their list. So it couldn't be a perfect film to start the series with. Let's take a look at our first shot. In essence, we'll be going frame by frame on each image, whether it's blocking, lighting, production design, whichever. All right, let's get into it. This first shot is great to start with because it's a typical Wong Kar-wai people through a doorway shot. So to start off, the framing is a simple 3/3 framing where on the left third you have the window and curtain taking up the left third. In the middle third, you have the two actors. And on the right third, you have the key light or dressing. So as you can see, the practical light here, the lamp is supposed to be lighting their faces. It's probably not actually lighting their face. On the left of them, left camera left behind the window and the curtain, there is probably the key light. It looks like it's a tungsten light that's coming underneath. So it's under lighting our main actress behind the curtain in the window. So it's just coming in and just hitting the edge of her chin ever so slightly. And then on the right, we have the key light, which is practical key light, not really a key light. This is probably just adding a little bit of fill light on the right side of their face, but we as the audience would assume that that is the light lighting the scene. In summary, we have a 3/3 blocking, really nice. We also have a blocking of the actors in the middle third. The lighting is a practical light that is faking the actual key light, but actually providing fill. This is right off the bat, this is great work. In terms of color, you'll see that the red on her dress kind of accents well with the red of the background, the red of the lamp. Throughout the film, Doyle uses this monochromatic style where he takes one color and he stretches it across all of its luminance within one frame. And some of this, I can't even explain that why it's working so well. It's the light green from the window with the curtain kind of just gives a good contrast with the dresses, the lamp, the background, everything just goes. Like if you took the background red and contrasted it with the window greenish white, they're almost like clear contrast, like white to black. So just framing it this way where you have your seeing in your foreground, you're seeing a window with a curtain out of focus, and then towards the middle ground you're seeing the actors, in the background you're seeing a clear nice color or gradient. All right, let's move on to shot two. Alright, for this shot, it's similar to the last shot. You have multiple actors in the middle ground and in the background. But in this, it's really interesting because you have the same thing again, but it's reversed. So in the foreground of the framing, you have production design placing lamps once again with a little bit of curtains in the back here. And then in the background, you have our lead actress alone reading the newspaper. But then around her, you have colors placed strategically in quarters of the frame that separates everything. So you have a blue behind the men, and then behind the mother you have a different blue. To the right of our actress we have more of like a magenta or purple, And then in the foreground on the right quarter, we have what looks to be, this is kind of like aqua or greenish for the lamp. It's really working here. There's a lot of separation. And when this shot is moving, it's a lot going on, but for some reason, you're trained right to the lead. And I think a lot of the reason why your eye goes right here is because of the exposure. So right on her skin, it looks like her skin is around like 60 or 70 IRE, and everyone else is around 40 or 50. Which in simple terms would be like a stop above everybody else. So the key light lamp right there that's lighting her against the purple back wall, that's giving her a stop more of light than everybody else. And which is about as bright as the foreground lamp on the right. But even then, it's human skin. So when human skin is lit higher than everything else, our eye, for some reason, just goes right to the human skin. We just see it right away. It's one of the main principles of cinematography, is just you want to light your lead actor or your key actor in the shot the clearest or the brightest. It almost looks like the frame is cut in half between the father and the mother in a funny way, but it's really just the corner of the wall right there. It's a really complicated frame, but it somehow works because of the color, the production design, and most notably the lamp in the back lighting our lead brighter than everybody else. So this would not work if the three people were lit brighter than her. This frame would be probably a little jumbled, and we wouldn't even notice her. We'd probably look at right them. So all right, let's move on to shot three. So shot three, this is our first shot for our actual lead. He's working in his office, and he's got this particular key light right above him. It's like a hard fluorescent, I think. And that's, fluorescents aren't really used commonly in filmmaking anymore, but they're great workhorses because we associate them with working in an office. So a lot of the times if you go to shoot in an office space, you have to deal with the fluorescents. But if you can bring your own fluorescents and you can control them, you'll have a very good time. A common fluorescent that people use is a Kinoflow 4 bank. This film was made in 2000, so I'm not entirely sure this is a Kinoflow. This might just be a normal fluorescent that Doyle rigged above. And the fixture behind him, that's an actual fluorescent behind him fixture above, where it's kind of like a greenish tone. I assume above the actor, he had a makeshift fixture. It wasn't simply like this. But what he did here is really beautiful because he's got a clean hard edge on top, and it kind of glides right down right over the shirt and onto the hand, when the hand is almost backlit by it, which is really nice. And in terms of production design and color, it's more bland behind him in this shot. The drawers and shelves behind him are just kind of like a murky gray. The wall is a pretty much like a desaturated orange brown. And the top walls are just this gross, dirty white, greenish white. Plus, the white shirt is just a pop. So the brightness of the white shirt is probably the brightest thing in the scene. It's probably about 2 to 3 stops brighter than the background. Also, in this shot, they're doing a particular technique that you see a lot of times in modern cinematography, which is called shooting into shadow. So the lead actor right here, his foreground of his skin is actually the negative side. So the fill side of his face, or the key side of his face that's filling all the light, is on the opposite side of the camera. So here you're shooting into him, but you're getting a edge of light that comes around the front of his nose, his eyes, his hair. It's got a top light, and it gives him kind of like this silhouette. And this just, it's really simple technique to make depth or make something look kind of, dare I say, cinematic. But you'll see it a lot in modern cinematography. If people don't know what to do in a certain situation to make something really have depth, like say the location doesn't have any depth, they will shoot into shadow. So they'll rig a couple lights behind the actor, shoot it over. It kind of edges the top of the head, hits the back. You get a soft wrap. It's really about the soft wrap that's really makes it look good. And you get something like this. It looks great. All right, let's go to shot 4. This is the same location, just lit very differently. And he's talking to, I assume, a coworker. This shot, right off the bat, what screams good about this shot is the production design. You may not notice it, but if you look at the shelves to the left of here, you have different colored shelves. Like, who thinks of this? This is genius. You got a blue, green, and gray. Makes your eye go right towards the actor automatically. If you looked left, you would see blue, green, gray. Your eye just shoots right back to the actor. And then on the right, you see a yellow wall. But it's metal, so it's shimmering. And it's similar brightness as the desk, so it's also going to train your eye back in. And then above, you have the fluorescent fixture again. And this time, it's just soft lighting both of them above. The coworker that he's talking to is getting a top light and a backlight since he's facing him. So you're shooting into shadow on the coworker, and then the main actor is just key lit perfectly. Like his exposure is right at key. It's perfect. And then behind him, you even have a doorway open with just a hint of light to get even more depth. So this whole frame, anywhere you look on this frame, it makes you go back to the lead. And this is just a simple two shot of people talking. This could have been done at a table with one light, and everything else around them could have been nothing. But for some reason, Doyle's just takes it to the extra step. He's got a wall on the right telling you to go left. A wall on the left telling you to go to right. He's got a back wall that just gives you depth. And then he's got a desk that's got a little bit of ambient light that's kind of training your eye forward as well. It's just a beautiful shot. It's nothing else to say about it. So I hope you like this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.